Hey guys, so we got Rocco's truck in the shop, and we're going to build a very simple stealth audio setup where he gets more sound quality than he ever did with the factory stuff and maintains most of his functionality as well. Here's my console, and you can see I've built two spacers. I rounded it over on the router, and I built a new floor underneath here to help support the enclosure. And underneath, you can see that there's vent holes to help allow the air to escape. That way it doesn't get trapped inside the enclosure or inside the center console. Here's my enclosure, a very simple box. Now, if you're wondering why this part's sticking out, what I was trying to do is I was trying to hit max width on the top because I was trying to get the trays to work. You'll see that later, but it didn't really work out. I have to, because the opening is only so big, and then when the enclosure gets down lower, it widens out a bit. So I'm going to still have to build beauty trims or little filler spots. So that way, when you put the tray in, nothing falls beside the subwoofer because you'll never be able to get at it. See on the back side, I put in some little feet. That way, I have to have another foot over here inside the center console. That way, we have enough clearance for the excursion of the subwoofer. That's what these guys are for. I tried to put an angle so when it's in there, the sound kind of directs in that general downfiring outside the console. That's what I'm trying to get out of it. We're really compromising to save on space in here. And then my good old trailer pin connector. That way, it's a simpler install as opposed to cutting a big hole, putting a terminal cup, and then relying on the terminal cup to seal the enclosure instead of just putting a small tiny hole and then having a plug that you can never install backwards anyways. I'm now just making a really simple finishing piece. So what this does is, because the enclosure can't be shaped to all the little corners on the top, so I'm just putting this piece in so when you put stuff into the center console, nothing drops down by the sub-enclosure. This will clear the middle tray. Yes, it's a bit weak here, but this will just get screwed in over here. I'll pre-drill it, countersink it, screw right into the enclosure. And then I rounded it over ever so slightly just to make it a little bit more finished where the tray goes. You don't really notice it, but I like to finish the wood a bit better if I can. And then on the back side, you can see that I put a little rabbet into it. So when I go ahead and carpet the whole thing, then it's gonna be easier for me to wrap. Now the panel's all carpet, just gotta clean it off. Just a little bit of dust on my table. And then see the back side. So that rabbet edge, run my knife along it, and then it cuts the carpet nice and easy and clean. Here's our doors. It might be a little bit hard to see, so we have sound dimming, so we have Dynamat on the outside skin, and then we have Hushmat's wave breakers, and then we have Dynamat again. And then here you see all our wiring, where it's soldered, shrink tube, and taped over, and then we have shrink tube again on top of our connectors. I am not a Ford guy, but I have to admit, I really like this truck. Like, if you gave me this truck for a really cheap price, I will buy it and I will totally rock this thing. I just have to say that. Rocco and I have very similar tastes where we think, for the most part, factory actually does a good job, but there's certain parts where it can improve upon. So you can see here he's changed the tires out. The truck's older, so need a new tire, so he has some good all-terrains. He does spend money on his dampeners, so he has the nice Bilstein shocks on there. And I can't tell, I have to ask him later, I don't know if this has a lift or not. I want to say he did level up the front at least, because the truck looks a little bit taller. Ford people, please correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the truck looks great. And I'm a huge fan of these 2011-ish kind of vehicles with the extended cab, because they're kind of shorter and because they have this stubby profile, they have this monster truck look. So I like them a lot. What did we do to the truck in the shop? Well, like I said before, Rocco is looking for more sound quality, but he doesn't want to see it. So that's fair enough. That's pretty much most of our customers now. They want better audio quality. They want to put a lot of gear in or a good amount of gear in, and they don't want to clutter up the whole vehicle, which is understandable because these are daily drivers. So what we did was to start with the head unit here. It's a Kenwood 893, 7-inch motorized screen. Now I like everything pretty much about it. Now a lot of head units, a lot of people complain are the startup times. That's a lot of head units still nowadays. So yes, I have to admit this has a little bit of a longer load time. And another thing that I have to say is, if you turn the truck on sometimes right away and throw in reverse, it might not catch the reverse signal because it's trying to boot up the system. The Maestro is integrating with the entire truck. So, you know, give it a good 20 seconds. You know, it gives you enough time to let at least the fluids circulate in the motor. So let's just say that this is our timer at least. So we don't really advise starting the car and driving off right away. Give the unit some time to boot up. Other than that, like you've seen on our other installs, the cool thing about this is we have vehicle information with the Maestro integration. See, my doors are open. So I'm gonna close one door, I'll close the back door, and we're going to close the driver's door. You can see all the tire pressure. Now, typically you see me show off gauges, that's cool, but over here he has this edge product. So what happens is, because they're both on the can high and can low, I had to hardwire the lines on the back end of the OBD2. Because he has the plug on the front for the edge product. What happens is, I was a little bit concerned, but what I found out, we can still communicate with this section of the vehicle's information. However, on the gauges, this won't do anything. It gets kicked out by the edge product, but they do work hand in hand, it seems. So at least we know that works, which is good. Another thing we did was we actually took out the factory USB, unplugged it, and made a small notch on the brackets. We didn't actually do anything to the face of this. And then our aftermarket USB plugs right in. So we have all the functionality. Also down here, I gave him an HDMI cable in case he wants to do screen mirroring. And he also made a request, because the unit has two USBs and it has this little slot here for wiring, we have another USB, which is where I would put my music. I would leave my music in here, tucked away. That way we're not putting any weight on this piece over here. This is just for guests. Like, oh, hey, I brought my phone or my USB. Can I plug in it? Go ahead. Over here, if you're gonna keep your music in here, just keep it here at all times. Now, where I lucked out with the truck is, Ford actually really builds a really nice center console. When I took it apart, we had this whole thing removed. It's actually really solid. It's very thick plastic because we wanted to put the sub enclosure into the center console. And we were a little bit concerned about that because typically when you put something like a subwoofer near plastic panels, it just rattles like crazy. However, this stuff is so thick. It reminds me of the thickness of the injection molded plastic on the MTX Thunderforms. It's like that pretty much. So he told me, I don't really use the center console. It's huge. Do whatever you want. I'm like, okay, cool. He's like, all I care about is keeping the center tray because it keeps my other miscellaneous stuff organized. I'm like, fair enough. We can do that. So we take this out so you guys can see. Here is our sub enclosure. Yes, Rocco, I have to vacuum this a bit more for you. Sorry. So this is the enclosure that you saw out of the truck earlier, and it took me a while. Like, it's a simple box. Boxes like that don't take long. What took long was trying to get it to fit nicely. So here at the very top is 10 inches from here to here. However, when it comes down, it's actually wider, but you can't build the box any wider than 10 inches because it won't even go in. So what we had to do was, and plus you have to compensate for a little bit of the material. The carpet makes it a little bit snug, which is what we like. And then you saw this bracing underneath before that's attached to it, that helps stiffen it all up and hold it all together so it doesn't want to resonate so much. So what we did was, because it was actually gapping fine here, but in the corners here we had big gaps where if you were to put something in the center console, stuff might fall in. So we, like you saw me router out that that panel before, that's where this goes. And then it's just screwed in, so I drilled holes, countersunk them, screwed them in, put them in evenly. And what helps is, because this little tray, because the box had to be clearanced a bit for the subwoofer to have room for excursion, the back doesn't click in that well. So these side pieces actually help for side-to-side movement, helping this hold in. I will play the system, but not here on YouTube. I will play it on my Facebook page, so you have to hop on my Facebook page to listen to how this thing sounds. So what else do we have for functionality? Okay, so we have the ability to look at tire pressure, which is nice when we go on road trips, because we can just quickly go to the gas station if we need to fill up with air, and our co-pilot can just tell us when to stop because the driver knows what tire pressure he or she likes to run. Cool. We also have steering wheel controls here, you can see. So volume goes up and down. Let's go into the source so we can actually see what's going on. So if you're on Sirius XM. Now the cool thing what we were able to do is this already had factory Sirius XM. So we just took the plug out of the unit, I made a couple adapters and plugged into my Sirius XM interface, that's aftermarket, and used the factory antenna. If you have factory antennas, you can reuse them. You don't have to put on that magnet on the top. I only put them if I have to. The factory antennas are really nice and they don't mess up the paint and they seal really well. So why, and it's in a good position because it's been tested, so why not use it? Of course, we also have our reverse cam. Now, the Kenwood has the ability to have guidelines. I took them off because our aftermarket camera already has them, and we had lined it up just with the hitch, so it's easier for him to park when he is towing or if he wants to hitch up. So this works nicely in conjunction with our rear parking aid. Because, yes, it's easy to see out the back of a truck because there's a bed, but the problem is the truck's so high you can't see a lot of low cars. So all this helps so we don't damage other vehicles. Okay, going back to our home screen. Now we can see the parametric, we can see the EQ. I like to look at that, just, I don't know, it's just a gimmick, but I like it. We have a compass. Of course we have navigation as well. But we have a quick view of the PS tire pressure sensors, which I really like. Rocco, I don't know why your left side is so different from the right. It's like it's set up for NASCAR because we're only turning left. Look at all that tire pressure on the right side. Please tell me why after. And then date and time, you know, but it's easy to cycle through. So this unit is leaps and bounds for display compared to the previous Kenwoods. If you guys read the previous Kenwoods, they're still good. This has the exact same functionality. It's just that the display is a lot prettier. It's a lot more to modern specifications and expectations, because we love the value of the Kenwood before, but it kind of looked kind of 90s. Nothing wrong with it. It was a great value. You got a lot of features for the money, but I'm like, it looks kind of 90s. So now they've come up to the same level as Alpine and Pioneer with their nice displays. Now they're all on an even playing field as far as aesthetics go. For speakers, we put in Hertz Energy speakers. I just like them because they're a mid-level speaker, don't require a lot of power to run, even though we have lots of power. And they're just a really well-balanced speaker. And we have Hushmat's wave breakers behind them, and the front doors are completely dynamatted. We will be changing out the rear speakers on a later day. This is the one item I really couldn't hide. We talked about putting it behind the rear seat, and I liked the idea, but the seat was too tight, and if I ever wanted to service this amp, I don't really want to take out the whole rear seat. The factory sub went back here, and this was the perfect place to put it, because we're not compromising any storage area, because he was never used to using this for storage. So to make up for not hiding the amp so much, we just hit all the wiring. So it's a nice looking piece at least, and it fits perfectly. We can still use the factory floor mats. It does not intrude, it doesn't overlap anywhere, so it fits nicely, keeping it in place, and all our wiring is hidden. What I did was I used Gorilla tape actually to harness the wiring up here. A lot of people just stuff it under carpet, which you can do, but I want to hold it more in place. There's actually also a channel in here, so all my speaker wiring runs in the channel, and one set goes into the center console for the sub, obviously, and then I have 9 wire going from up in the dash back to the amplifier, and also our power wire runs down there. So we have power wire on the passenger side, speaker wire in the middle, and our RCAs run down the left side, keeping everything far away. Not only for any chance of engine noise occurring, we don't want that, but also it was easier to lay out the wiring because we spread it throughout the cab, keeping everything low. And then we have a piece of wood underneath this. We don't want to drill any holes in the floor, and we have a piece of wood securing the amplifier. That way it doesn't go anywhere. I didn't have a tailgate cam available for this truck, so we decided to go with a universal one. There's nothing wrong with the small universal ones. You just have to be a little bit creative. We got lucky here. There's no metal behind here on the bumper, so we flush mounted here. That way it lines up with the hitch. You can see it nicely. Also, the hitch is going to protect it if he does happen to back up into a concrete barrier or something, you know, when you're parking these things. So we're trying to take all things into consideration. We know he lowers his tailgate every time he gets into the truck, so we're not worried about him stepping on it or kicking it because he's lowering the tailgate every time. Overall, I'm super happy with the truck. It looks the same, it sounds so much better, it has way more functionality. It's just like any new truck on the road, because this truck's only 2011 and it's in fantastic condition. Why would you just go buy a new truck because you want to have a screen or you want to have USB connectivity or you want to have more features? You can just come to a shop like ours and update the thing. And yes, he did drop a good chunk of change off the bat, but in the long run, it's way cheaper than making truck payments nonstop. Because let's say you guys have trucks for 5 years, you finally pay it off, and then what, you go out and buy another truck and make more payments? Maybe if the truck's in good condition, you go ahead and upgrade it. Or you go buy a used truck, save the money on the depreciation, and then come into a shop like ours and update it. Remember to go on my Facebook page to see how, or to listen how this thing sounds, and also check out my Instagram, AnthonyJ350. Also, don't forget to check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca. We'll be right back.